Have you ever felt sluggish after a big meal? Or maybe you've noticed a dip in energy or mental clarity after eating and need to take a nap? Don't ignore these symptoms. This fatigue and mental brain fog is actually a sign that your blood sugar got too high after eating. Over time, high blood sugars will lead to type 2 diabetes. The good news is there are so many simple diet and lifestyle changes that you can make now to avoid or reverse high blood sugars. I'm Dr. Morgan Nolte, founder of Zivly, where we help you lose weight, keep it off, and get healthy with a low insulin and inflammation lifestyle. If you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you never miss out on tips that help you live a healthier, happier life. One of my favorites is to take a short walk after meals to help balance your blood sugar and boost your energy. And I know it sounds too simple to be true, right? But the science behind this is actually very compelling. By the end of this video, you'll know exactly why walking after meals is one of the easiest and most effective ways to support healthy blood sugar levels. And if walking isn't your thing, I'll also share some great alternatives. First, let's talk about what happens to your body after you eat. When you eat a meal, especially one with carbohydrates, those carbs break down into glucose, which enters your bloodstream. This causes your blood sugar to rise, triggering insulin to be released to help shuttle that glucose into your cells for energy or storage. So if there's too much glucose at once, or if your body isn't responding well to insulin, that blood sugar spike might be too high, leading to energy crashes, cravings, and even long-term issues like insulin resistance and diabetes. So here's where walking comes in. It acts as a natural blood sugar regulator. Studies show that walking after meals can significantly reduce blood sugar spikes. When you move, your muscles use glucose for energy, soaking the glucose in like a dry sponge soaks in water. Thanks to your muscles using that glucose right away, the amount of glucose that stays in your bloodstream goes down. And the best part is that this muscle demand use of glucose doesn't require any insulin. So it helps keep your insulin levels down too. If you're wearing a continuous glucose monitor, you can test walking after meals and see for yourself that it really does work. Research supports the best results when you move immediately after the meal instead of waiting 30 or 60 minutes. Now, the current advice is to get at least 150 minutes of aerobic activity per week. But as it turns out, that's not the best advice for blood sugar management because it treats all 150 minutes the same. Like if you do 45 minutes, 3 times a week, you're good to go. And yes, any activity is better than none, but more timed and targeted activity can be more effective for blood sugar management than long aerobic workouts, which may be great news if you feel like you don't have an hour to spend at the gym. One study found that just a 10 to 15 minute walk after meals helped lower post-meal glucose more effectively than a single 45 minute walk at another time of the day. Another study showed that walking for just 2 to 5 minutes after eating made a measurable difference in glucose levels. That means you don't need to hit the gym for an hour. Just a short walk after meals can help stabilize blood sugar, improve digestion, and prevent that dreaded energy crash. So how much of a difference are we talking about here? Research suggests that walking after meals can lower post-meal blood sugars by 10 to 30%, depending on factors like the size of your meal, your insulin sensitivity, and how long you walk. For example, if your blood sugar would typically spike to 180 after a meal, a short walk could bring it down to 140 to 160 instead. And that's a big difference, especially if you're working to improve insulin resistance, prevent or reverse diabetes. But what if you can't go for a walk? No worries. There are other ways to get the same benefits. Try some light bodyweight exercises like squats, lunges, or calf raises. Now, my personal favorite is bodyweight squats, or you could just stand up and sit down from a chair if you need a little bit more support for your joints or balance. One study found that performing 10 bodyweight squats every 45 minutes during an 8.5 hour sitting period significantly improved blood sugar control compared to uninterrupted sitting. Now, they also found these regular bursts of activity, or as they called them, activity snacks, help your body use protein from food more effectively to build and strengthen muscles. And this intermittent activity was more effective than a single 30-minute walk at reducing post-meal glucose levels. That's why if I'm not up for a walk, bodyweight squats are my go-to exercise. Just 5 to 10 reps can help move glucose into your muscles. If you're at work or home, march in place or do some squats or sit to stands, or try a few minutes of gentle stretching. Even standing up and moving around for a few minutes right after you eat is better than sitting still for hours at a time. Let's talk about how you can make this a habit. Here are some quick tips. Pair your walk with something enjoyable, like listening to your favorite podcast or talking with a friend or walking your pet. Start with small, realistic goals, like 2 to 5 minutes or 10 squats after every meal. If you're out to a restaurant, take a lap around the parking lot or walk to the end of the block and back before heading home. Or you could try parking farther away from the restaurant to get those steps in. Walking after meals is such a simple habit, but the impact on blood sugar, energy, and overall health is huge. Give it a try and let me know what you think in the comments. Have you noticed a difference when you move after eating? Are you more energetic, less tired, more engaged? Along with healthy diet and lifestyle changes, if you're looking to do all that you can to prevent or avoid blood sugar medications because of their cost or side effects, then check out Super Berberine by Sugar MD. It can help lower blood sugars more effectively than other berberine supplements for two reasons. First, it contains dihydroberberine, which is a more bioavailable form of berberine. And second, it contains highly concentrated Ceylon cinnamon. So much that it's like you're getting 3 tablespoons of regular cinnamon in just one serving. There's a link in the description for you to learn more about Sugar MD and Super Berberine. And if you want more evidence-based tips on blood sugar control, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so that you don't miss a new video. Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out this one next, where I reveal 7 tips to reduce blood sugar spikes after meals.